Hey guys, what's up? It's AppCritics, MapCritics.com, and in this video I'm going to be showing you maps on iOS 14. So here we have the maps on iOS 14, so we can just go ahead and search for a place to start. So we can search for San Francisco. And when we search for it, we can see we have all these options, so it'll tell you about it. And then you can see that we have a look around feature. So just a look around feature does as the name suggests. It just gives you kind of like a street view of a certain place in San Francisco. So that's really unique. And then you can just hit done. And then what we can do is actually just scroll on over and can see that there's images from Wikipedia and it actually has guides now as well. So there's particular guides for what to do in a city, where to shop, where to have some outdoor activities, and where to get groceries, where public art is, affordable takeout. So this is really unique that they added this, so we can just go ahead and press on it. And then just gives you all these different trails in San Francisco for running. Now you just go ahead and just look at the particular guide, and you can also save the guide. So you can see it will give you some more information on a particular trail. So the SCA trail, the Aptos Rancho trail, and we have all these different ranch trails to take a look at. So this is really interesting that we have all these guides in the Apple Maps now. So this is definitely a nice hands-on feature that Apple has to offer now. Now what we can also do is the flyover. So this flyover feature is just a feature that just shows you around San Francisco by using your gyroscope. So you can see that you can just use the gyroscope, the accelerometer, and some machine learning models to just show a city. And this is just a really unique view, and you can see how high quality it is. There isn't any lag whatsoever, and this is on my iPhone XS Max, so it's definitely doing the job, I must say. Now you can also start a city tour. So when we start a city tour, I'll just go ahead and it'll just show you the key landmarks and history of the city. So that's really interesting. We do have the option to pause the tour at the bottom as well, so that's also good. So you can see it's just showing the Golden Gate Bridge in San Francisco. So you can see it right there. Now you can just go ahead and just hit the X. And now we do have the ability to add some new guides. So you can just compile all your guides here and just create a new guide. And we can just do that. So that's also good, but it's not working right now as it's not the full iOS 14 release just yet. Now, in terms of other features, we do have the cycling feature. So with the cycling, what it allows you to do is it'll do some bike routes depending on where you are. So this will work in New York, LA, Shanghai, San Francisco, and Beijing. So those are the five launch cities that will get access to this. And the cycling will just once again find you the most efficient route. It'll take out all the construction and congestion and just find the best route that has all the bike lanes. And it's very efficient. It'll tell you if there's stairs, if there's high elevation, and anything like that. Now there also is the electric vehicle integration in maps. So it'll tell you where the closest chargers are, the best efficient route so you save the most battery, and it won't give you any range anxiety that you would run out of battery in your car. So this is just made for all those electric vehicles. Now this is just a solid feature, and Apple is definitely moving in the right direction. So those are the major features of the maps. It's still solid. Now, especially with the cycling and electric vehicle integration, Apple Maps is headed for the right direction. Now, I also must say that there is the flyover feature, which is great, and the city guides is also even better. So it basically gives you some Yelp integration. So it just tells you where to eat, where to shop, and everything like that. So that's definitely good. So once again, we can just take a look at one more guide. So let's say, for example, this one. So you can just go ahead and just look at the guides right here. So we have all the San Francisco guides. So let's say, for example, where the best public art is. And then you can see it'll just tell you on the map right here. And then what we can do is just simply save the guide. We can share the guide. And then we have the ability to take a look at the street art in a particular location. Then you can just hit the plus sign, and then it'll just add it to a new guide. So just, it's like the save feature on Instagram. So it's really good in that way. So those are all the options with the guides, and just gives you a brief synopsis on it. So that is basically what the maps does and when it's working in its full capacity. So I hope you've thoroughly enjoyed this video on the Apple Maps feature on iOS 14. If you did, be sure to smash that like button down below. Also be sure to subscribe for more great content, and be sure to follow me on all my social media platforms, of Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. My username there is AppleCritics. Be sure to subscribe for more great content, and thanks for watching.